everyone. Thank you very much for coming. In the past two conferences of ENOJP, I gave my presentation on Watsuji Tetsuro, mainly on his concept of aidagara in relation to a notion of action in Barcelona and in relation to the terms mono and koto in Brussels as its background. Today, I'd like to go beyond Watsuji by introducing another philosopher, another celebrity of this conference, Nishida Kitaro. Since I've been not familiar with Nishida's philosophy in comparison to Watsuji's, my examination of his philosophy is not in depth yet at this moment, but at least today I'd like to make it clear one of the major differences between Watsuji and Nishida, especially on their understanding of the predictability of nature. I think this will give us an insight of the nature of environmental issues and our ethics in general. Okay. So this is the outline. First, I will explain the background of this research, and next, I will try to point out that in Watsuji's philosophy, the predictability of nature plays an important role, but missing a role in his ethics, but missing its unpredictable aspect and its significance to our life. And then I will explain an unpredictable nature that can be found in Nishida's philosophy. Finally, with an aid of Miki Kiyoshi, I'd like to show an antagonism of two ethics. This research started to solve a problem in environmental ethics. While some of you may find too old-fashioned in the history of philosophy, we can still find the conflict between anthropocentrism and non-anthropocentrism, basically a conflict between human and nature. Nowadays, we can find many philosophers to reject the dichotomy of humanity and nature. And one of them is a trend of network theories which see agent of an action as a complex of human and non-human, like Bruno Latour and Peter Paul Fairbeck. I find another network theory in Watsuji's philosophy, that is action network, action nexus, koiteki renkan. Watsuji's ethics is based on his understanding of human existence in betweenness that includes the environment within itself. There, a key element to embody the environment within us is a repetition of human life and ethics. Today, I'd like to point out the missing aspect in Watsuji's philosophy, that is the unpredictability of nature in us and its significance. So first, I'd like to show why predictability is important in Watsuji's philosophy. Climaticity, or fudosei in Japanese, in the book Climate, is a concept that is often discussed in Watsuji's studies. This concept is explained as a structural moment of human existence. Our ways of living is formed based on an accumulation of self-understanding of past generations. Here I find that the repetition of the same phenomena of climate is an indispensable aspect. And on the other hand, in the book Ethics as a Study of Human Being, Watsuji develops the idea of action nexus or koiteki renkan that is explained as a synonym of aidagara or human relationships. An action is not a mere physical movement, but interpreted in a social context. We are always acting as someone, like a teacher or as a student, businessman, father, sister, or so. And this is because human existence in betweenness has twofold characteristics, social and individual. The human relationships themselves are subjective and invisible. They are objectified in our concrete bodies and environment, the things around us. What are involved in the action nexus is not only human bodies. The environment, what we call environment, is included in the as the expressions of action nexus or human relationships and takes part in its development. This is an application of Wilhelm Dieterle's idea of nexus of life, expression, and understanding. We are living in vast ocean of expressions. Landscape is a scene of human community. No environment as external world exists in the true sense. This action nexus has a repetitive structure that is called as an movement of coming back, or kirai no undo. When we conduct a certain action, like walking towards somewhere, we are expecting a certain future relationships. We walk towards school or home, working place, etc. And this is possible because past relationships appear as possible future relationships and support our present action. Watsuji considers this as the temporality of action nexus. And based on this structure, the movement of coming back, good and evil emerge. Watsuji proposes a simple definition of good and evil. Good is responding to trust, and evil is not responding to trust. Here, trust is indeed an expectation based on shared past. And this repetition is again not established by collection of human bodies, but emerges in the complex of them and so-called nature or the environment. Watsuji talks about rhythms that is established in human society. Day, week, month, season, and year, they are established for enabling the communal human life. Watsuji considers human relationships as subject, and what we observe are expressions of objectification of this subject, like the use of the term subject in Kant and Dieterle. The subject itself cannot become a target of analysis. I have a certain relationship with each of you in this room, but I cannot point out them in the way that it is here. This is our relationship, but it's invisible. It's expressed in a certain way through our body or the things around us. Watsuji considers that human relationships develop in the repetition of expression and understanding of these expressions. But today I'd like to point out that there is a problem lying here. While saying that these human relationships or action nexus develop, Watsuji does not really provide how a certain change in human life occurs. That will be the arrow that I made in red. So, what changes the models of relationships in a particular culture? Indeed, in our life, there are many things that are unpredictable and uncontrollable, like disaster or emotion. Disaster, like as in Fukushima, as in the case of Fukushima, it was unpredictable phenomena, but then after this phenomena, there was a creation of a new communal form. So it was really significant in our life. like there are many architects helped in establishing a new community in Fukushima and also in Kumamoto. One of them is Ito Toyo, who established a project of home for all, and he is trying to establish a new communal form. Like, yeah, he has built several homes for having a certain communal event, and try to think ideal way of living after the disaster. Another unpredictable aspect is art, that as Bruno points out, in the beginning, an artist himself does not know what he is making, but the artworks are made after the struggle with the things, and it's not a mere materialization of a complete image that he has in his mind. And a researcher, Nakano Yuko, she connected this Bruno's idea with Nishida's performative intuition and creativity, and I like to explore more about Nishida's notions. So, unpredictability of nature in Nishida's philosophy. In an inquiry into the good, Zen no Kenkyu, what Nishida defined good as satisfaction of the innate or internal demand, as Saito-sensei today explained today. Nishida says the absolute good is satisfaction of the demand of the fundamental unifying power of consciousness or of a personality. In other words, personality is the activity of the unifying power of the universe. Satisfaction of the demand makes each of us an indispensable part of the evolution of the universe. And I would say, although I'm still studying, I would say Nishida's view of this universe hasn't changed throughout his work until the later part of Nishida's philosophy. In the article called "The World as the Dialectical Universal," 弁証法的一般者としての世界, he explains the mediator M as place or dialectical universal, and here, so he already has the idea of place or dialectical universal, but then still this is explained in the way that the foundation of our actions are impulse of the universe. I quote in the article Human Existence, a historical trend cannot go beyond itself. To acquire a new life, we must return to the bosom of creative nature again, 創造的自然. From there, we will come with the new power of creation. A new life will be born within us. There are always irrational animal things moving out that are incommensurable with the abstract logic. Incommensurable with the abstract logic. There is a great, great cultural crisis. However, as long as it is constructive in the sense of performative intuition, from that which is created to what. To that which creates, 作られたものから作るものへとして, it works as creativity of a new history again, as being considered as rational. And researcher Nagao Michitaka points out that Since reality is the world in which gives birth and also kills, it does not allow a prediction of what we will emerge from there. For analyzing Nishida's philosophy, and Higaki sensei in his book and Morino-san, they explain, they use the word vertical to express Nishida's notion, the vertical as eternal now and absolute nothingness, against the horizontal, which is self and thing and self and other and horizontal, that is the relationship between self and thing, self and other and time. So vertical aspect is coming out of nowhere. And I will apply Miki Kiyoshi's distinction of maxim ethics and human ethics. Maxim ethics, 確率的原理, Miki Kiyoshi explains that is based on our customs, and in Bergson's term, closed society, and that is important in organic period and communal sense. And on the other hand, human ethics, 人間的倫理, is developed by genius, so tensei, and open society in Bergson's idea, that becomes important in critical period, and that is pushed by new knowledge and science. So I would say, by combining the idea of Nishida in Watsuji's framework, the nature at the bottom of our life is coming, is actually the moving force of our life, of our history. If it appears in our body, it becomes like the person becomes, is considered as a genius or tensei, and the nature can come as natural disaster as well. But they all happen in human existence, in betweenness, in Watsuji's understanding. So finally, there is a conflict between sociality and naturalness of human existence. What we can discuss is the possibility of harmonization between sociality and naturalness or creativity of human existence in the finiteness, not the environmental problems of human versus nature. And now I'll say environmental problem is the acceleration of naturalness or creativity. And that is what the term turbulent times describes, and also what Zygmunt Bauman called wicked modernity. Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay, so we have 8 minutes for questions. If anyone has something,
after maybe since I already asked something, maybe somebody else wants a choice.
Just quickly, thank you.
Thank you.
I'm wondering, in light of the unpredictability of nature for Nishida, how would he explain the possibility of science, especially the hard sciences, which rely upon predictability?
I would say, let me take this as my homework. Thank you. I don't know enough to answer this question.
Lorenzo?
Yeah. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for the wonderful topic. I was wondering, since when you're talking about no crisis, no sudden happenings in Watsuji, I think it does address both emotions and sudden tragedies, and it does it in Fuda. Well, exactly when he's talking about the typhoonic character of actually about Japanese culture when he's dealing with Shimeyakana Rikijo. And these are the same examples that in the ethics would be classified as evil, actually. But all these sudden outbursts of negativity, and then like getting outside, like, manifesting themselves, and then disappearing again. And the, he uses the typhoon in Japan exactly. Like, it's really fudo. So in your last slide, like when you when you're dealing with nature, Nishida always uses shizen. But one could say that like this fudo is not just seasons, but also these very sudden happenings that also imply human nature, and this sort of negativity is also some an engine for history, like a history of human relationships, a history of fudo-se itself.
Yeah, thank you very much for pointing out.
I think it's a point in Watsuji where it does address.
So Japan is considered as the typhoon, like the climate within the region of climate of typhoon, but it is always it's already in its fixed fudo already, and he doesn't really describes that changes our life. I would say he might consider, but he didn't really say how. So our life changes after the attack of typhoon. It's already in like a. I would say static form, static style. Yeah, we can develop from his understanding, but he didn't really. He said like in ethics, he talked about the earthquake in Tokyo, and that that changed. That made a cut in our communication system, but then, but it's just a missing aspect that he didn't really describe how what kind of change is made after this. So it's not really like. Not just how can I say? It's something that we can add to his theory. Not just I'm not really kind of I'm not saying that what is his analysis is useful, not useful. But we can develop further by making more.
Real. James?
Thank you for this. It's interesting and raises a question that I've had for some time for you, and maybe now I can state more clearly. When you talk about action nexus, okay, you have three kind of major models. The first is human beings collaborating with each other. Don't work alone, things are done collaboratively. You have human beings in collaboration with the cycles of nature. They do things year after year because of the changing environment. And you have individual human beings working with tools, which are extensions of themselves. In each case, you have a kind of activity that takes place in interrelationship. But I wonder if that's really koite kanden. That seems to me kanden ni okeru koi. What if it is the relationship itself, the nexus, that is performative? Not just the human being in connection with something else, even though it's about ethics, so it has to do with humans. But what if it's the nexus itself that's performative? A really koite kanden.
Then
human being. So would seem to me that the primary model then would be breathing.
Mm.
Who breathes?
Mm.
Is it the environment that breathes? Is it I that breathe? No, no, it's the connection that breathes.
Mm.
It's not a kyodo sagyo. There's not two parts collaborating, working together. It's something that happens. And what kind of a happening is it? It's a performative relationship, not a dead, static relationship. It's a koitikikana, a performative relationship. So I think that if you're going to criticize use Nishida to criticize Watsuji, that would be the way to criticize him. Nishida would put the emphasis more on the kanren without a subject.
Thank you very much
for
thank you very much for your comment. And that is really crucial, that I think Watsuji tried to criticize Nishida in the understanding of the word koi, because Watsuji says that koi is always, koi is not a male movement, but done in a certain social context, and that means that there is always a need for individuality and sociality. So if you say the nexus itself is performing, there is no individual that expressing, if the nexus is itself is performative, there is nobody. But indeed, I'm here to talking to you, and there's me and you, that we are individual in the sense, but in that in the nexus. So it in Watsuji's case, nexus itself. How can I say?
But don't you think that maybe that could be a kind of abstraction? That there's you and me and the words going back and forth across the room? And then at a much more basic level, there's something else going on. These are just abstractions, little fictions that we pick up on.
So I think...
Fundamentally, it's the nexus that's active. And what's his name? Gadamer tried to say once, we don't have conversations. You and I sit down and talk about something. We walk in a stream called conversation. And we stand there for a while and we walk out of it. You know? And everything is flowing and we're just participating. And it's the fictions that allow us to make our ethics. That's fine. But if Nishida is criticizing the ethics, he would do it from an ontological point of view and say that the tsukuru mono isn't that important. Tsukurareta mono, in the sense of subject, isn't that important. You know? The next
Right. So, I would say, so if we really try to use Nishida as the basic framework, then we need to, presuppose a certain metaphysics of nature or the universe. And my aim is rather the sphere of ethics. So as Bergson pointed out, we need to first distinguish the two ethics, two societies, I would say. So the ethics of two closed society and ethics of open society. Although Bergson said the ethics of open society is more important, but I think ethics of closed society is also important. And because that is the not everyone can be genius in the sense. It's the ethics of normal person normal people. And I say those movement of trying to solve the environmental issues like slow life and those, they are trying to keep the life of closed society as well, because that is kind of denied in modern context. So, and then, yeah, trying to, yeah, think this issue. Thank you very much.